Hello, friends. We have another interesting question. This question stems about the mark of the beast. Is the mark of the beast in the past? Has it happened in the past? Or is it future? Well, friend, this really stems from dispensational teaching where we have amillennialists. You know, you have the premillennialists, you have the postmillennialists, then you have the amillennialists, meaning that there's no millennium. Everything that has that's in the book of Revelation has already happened in the past, and that some emperor, either Nero or Antiochus Epiphanes, I think that's his name, that this stuff about the mark of the beast happened already in the past. But friends, we want to look at what the mark of the beast crisis is centered around and who does it affect. So in the book of Revelation, chapter 13, this is where the mark of the beast is mentioned. If you see in chapter 13 and verse number 17, it says that no man might buy or sell save he that hath the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. And so when we look at the fact that the mark of the beast is dealing with having the mark, the name, or the number of his name, this is dealing with a crisis. So how do we know it's a crisis? We'll go back a few verses before that. And it says in verse 16, he hath power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship, it has to deal with worship, that would not worship the image of the beast, that they should be killed. And he causes all, I mean everybody, small or great, rich or poor, free or bond, to receive in their right hand, receive the mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. And so this is talking about a time which is going to affect the entire world. Why do we know that? How do we know that? Well, we can go back and we can look in verse 14. Deceiveth them which dwell on the earth. Them that dwell on the earth. So this is going to affect the entire earth by the means of those miracles which he had done in the sight of the beast, saying unto them that dwell on the earth, those people that dwell on the earth, that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by the sword and did live. And so what this is telling us is that this is a worldwide thing. This is going to affect everyone on the earth, not just a few people in the Roman Empire, but it's going to affect all people on the earth. It's not going to just be a few Christians here and a few Christians there, but it's going to affect everyone that is on the earth. And so the mark of the beast crisis was not confined to a single area in the past, but it's going to be affecting people in the future, where it's going to be worldwide. It's going to be worldwide. And so if you go through Revelation chapter 13, I want you to take the time to underline the word worship. It shows up several times. The mark of the beast crisis has to do with worship. Let me show you. It says here in verse 4, and they worshiped the dragon. They worshiped the dragon, which gave power to the beast, and they worshiped the beast. They worshiped the beast. That's in verse 4. In verse 8, it says, all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, shall worship him, shall worship the beast, whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. So it has to do with worship. And then here in verse 12, he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, that's caused the earth and them that dwelleth thereof to worship the first beast. It has to do with worship. The mark of the beast crisis has to do with worship. And so what we have coming up in the last days, not just from the past, but in the last days, that there's going to be a crisis that is centered around, that has to do with worship. It has all to do with worship. So the mark of the beast crisis, it didn't just happen in the past, because if it was Antiochus Epiphanes or just the Roman Empire, then that would not fulfill the prophecy, because the prophecy deals with worship and it affects the entire world. It affects the entire world, the entire inhabitants of the world, and especially those whose names are not written in the Lamb's Book of Life. So When we look at the mark of the beast crisis, understand two important things. That this is going to be a crisis that affects everyone on the earth. And number two, if your name is not written in the Lamb's Book of Life, you can and will receive the mark of the beast. Stay tuned for more. May God bless you.